changes we had to share.
Video 12. There we are then, chaps. Royal fans again. Going through Tollerton.
It's very posh area, Tollerton. So posh they won't let the cable people put cable down so you can only have Sky.
Something like that. Anyway, today we're off to a place that I never thought I'd be allowed in. And sadly, no, it's not Ali Fraser's house because we found it. But today, Central Studios, or what was Central Studios, is now known to Nottingham University staff, in short, as KMC. KMC being King's Meadow campus. And King's Meadow campus obviously being what was Central Studios and in later time Colton Studios. We're going down there today, got permission to go in. Security will be trotting about with us. And Colin Russell and Deborah Kerby, who fans will know the name of if they're at the gathering. And again, they might know the name even if they weren't at the gathering. May have just read it on the webpage. But yeah, two people that worked on Auf Wiedersehen Pet. Oh, come on, man. What's going on? As you can see, all the gits are out again. But yeah, Colin Russell, Deborah Kerby will be joining me down there. And hopefully giving us some nice stories in relation to the building as we walk around. When we go in the building, I don't know how much sort of leeway we've got, whether we can look in every room or, you know. Because obviously there's offices there now. Some of it's been converted to offices and people are going to be working. Plus with it being university is going to be students about, tidy bear tackle. Yeah, you never know. Tidy boiler. So yeah, we've basically got permission to go to the old Central Studios. Around the outside, some of the inside, I'm guessing. It's rumoured that some of the inside, or part of it at least, is still set up as studio. I said that to my missus. good. So some was still, you know, a bit of studio. So, it's still set up for my feeders, ain't it? I was like, no, bloody hell. So I don't think it'd be sat there all them years just, you know, doing nothing because they'd finished with it. But anyway, what we saw was the Barley Mow. Hopefully we'll get some reference to today. Same with Cross Keys Hotel, Dennis and Norma having dinner. Stool Pigeon, chaps it on my stool! Remember that sort of studio? So, as I say, if you was at the gathering, you'll have an idea of this anyway. Because Deborah Kerby told us, and also some of the other chaps, you know, filled us in with some nice facts. But the general idea today, go down, see what we can get. Inside and outside around the building. See if we can locate where the blue hut was at the start of Return of the Seven Part 1. I hope one of them remembers. but also down there in the campus itself, there's a company called Anglo-American, and these chaps basically do like all sorts of bits and bobs for TV programs and bloody films when it comes to rigging up for like cameras and driving and stuff. Some of the gits are out of time. And as far as I understand it, anyway, these chaps weren't actually situated there at the time of filming when Central was still doing Auf Wiedersehen Series 2. I don't know, I might have to get some corrected information on that. That's what I've been told. It says, oh, they weren't down there then, but they are now. And I've been to see them, shown them some of the Series 2 keyrings, mate. And I was quite surprised at the keyrings. Oh, can I have them? I was like, they're mine. I said, I'll see if we can get you some keyrings. Which isn't a problem, I'm sure. But yeah, they remember the camper van, Barry's van, Wayne's BM. Wayne's BM had a story behind it. Apparently, a woman that brought it after it was used in the series, apparently, she gave him a fraudulent banker's draft. Said, oh, we never saw the car again. We got the money in the end, but we never saw the car again. It's like, bloody hell. Said, obviously, Barry's van was sold somewhere in Nottingham, and people would always see Barry's van in Nottingham because the chap used to have a for sale sign in it all the time with like a ridiculous price because he knew its history, you know. That sadly disappeared over the years, as did the camper van, and as did Wayne's, as we know, Wayne's BM. Concentrate. Oh, come on, man. So yeah, down here is Anglo-American. They told me that when they were sort of working on it at the time, that Barry's van used to get a constant bloody tip over of salt water onto it to make it look more knackered and sort of old, you know, weathered sort of thing. Oh yeah, I used to... He doesn't talk like this, but yeah. We said, oh yeah, I used to pour salt water on it quite often. Just try and make it old, knackered, you know, starting to rust. Give it the sort of battered effect. Like it had some, been through some jobs with Barry sort of thing. And yeah, it was good to hear people talking on the same wavelength. Just like at Trial Services with Andrew Bamford, you know, he had his phone ready, had the pictures ready to show me and compare and angle and, you know, see what was what. But same with these Anglo-American chaps. One of them, they have got a website online, I'll have to put a link on the end of the video or something. But one of them, he's got his picture with Wayne. The chap's name is Wayne as well, but one of them's got his picture with Gary Oldton, aka Wayne, on his on the website for Anglo-American. And they work on all sorts of things these days. He's telling me they was doing some Hollyoaks lately. And bloody, they've done Crossroads in the past, and bloody, the film, there was a film done Trial Services called Hush, and on the website that's listed as well. So I'm guessing anything sort of in and around Nottingham and even out of Nottingham, they've done quite a bit on. There's a hell of a list on the website of stuff they've worked on. Now, Auf Wiedersehen Pet, you know, just being one of them. So a lot of history with the chaps. I'm not sure if they'll talk on camera or not. He seems alright enough, but I'd phoned him yesterday. And says, oh, we're all a bit busy, it always seems like we're a day behind. I was like, okay. I says, we'll just say no, I'll be down with a camera today, etc, etc. So if I can get them chaps on, because, you know, they've got the stories, and we'll see what happens. But for now, chaps, we're on Lenton Lane, the University of Nottingham, the gatehouse, if you want to call it that, is just on the right hand side. So let's see if I can go in. So basically, Nottingham in the early 80s, down the Lenton area at least, it was only just sort of like coming to life. You had all these buildings slowly popping up, one of which, of course, was Central Studios. Early 80s. Now, quoting from an article here that I found online by Mr. Roddy Buxton, it says that ATV was forced to restructure and was subsequently reborn as Central Independent Television, hitting the airwaves in January 1982. So even before, you know, the first series. But when it comes down to it, they had to move operations from Boreham Wood down out Southway there and get something in the Midlands. These Midlands had Central Studios in Birmingham, which has sadly been recently demolished. Not sure if part of it's still there, but yeah, demolished mostly. And they said, look, basically a 16 acre site at Lenton Lane was chosen for the new complex. Again, I'll say in these early 80s. Birmingham was up, Nottingham was basically going up, and it was officially opened by Prince Philip in March 1984, but nothing was down Nottingham at one point when it comes to studios until Central arrived. And as it says, it was a 16 acre site. And quoting from the article again, on the outskirts, Nottingham City Centre was chosen to construct a new complex. It was part of a constantly evolving industrial estate, which is bloody right, because it's still being changed today. It also had direct links to Nottingham Ring Road, enabling the new facilities to be accessed quite easily from most surrounding cities. And obviously the Ring Road's still there today. It takes you up to the 52, the M1, A46 if you get far enough. The new complex began operation in autumn of 83, but was officially opened in 84. It was designed to be spacious, provide facility to extend if so required, and also provide adequate floor space for the major production work that was once carried out at Elstree, which of course is where Auf Wiedersehen Pet Series 1 was done, as well as bits of Hamburg and Dusseldorf. There was also extra space for small presentation studios, plus a new permanent base for Central News East, which you will see in the video when Colin and Deborah tell us about the newsrooms on the upper floors. But yeah, this was one big studio, obviously bullseye, blockbusters, family fortunes, Price is Right, and Upper Hand, obviously Boone sort of was based down there when it comes to editing and what have you. A lot of Boom was done on a location in Nottingham, I think, after Series 3. I always have to remember that and sort of check it. He also had shows like Wolf, which many Nottingham people remember, and always a series, also a series called Barbara, which had Sam Kelly in, that was in Porridge as Bunny, or Bunny Warren. And they did three series of Barbara, and again, you know, that was based down at Central Studios. Upper Hand was 90 to 96. And I think Crossroads went on there until 2003. But yeah, as you see from the pictures that have been shown, early stages of building, and then as it stands today, owned by Nottingham University. We're gonna go
to the gatehouse.
Well, okay, if you're going slow, mate, I'm off. Hello, sir.
Hello.
I'm expected down here for 2 o'clock, Mr. John Astill.
Alright.
I'm doing some filming around in and outside of the building, but I'd like to get to Anglo first, just have a word with them, see if I can get them in on the filming or not.
Right.
There are two other people coming to film with me called Deborah Kerby and Colin Russell. They said if we ask at the gatehouse, should it be fine? I said that hopefully.
Yeah, it's just paying display, you know that, don't they?
Is it a paying display?
Oh, yeah.
It's a bloody campers, man.
3 years now, don't matter. Park in the car park, just past the island where that yellow triangle is.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's a paying machine. Careful, because you're good man,
they're stopping
£75.
Yeah?
Yeah.
£75? Bloody hell, man. Well, thanks for the warning. Pay and display. Oh my god. I can't believe that, man. Well, I'm going to Anglo first, I'm sorry. Just have a quick look in. Can hear my exhaust clunking on these little speed ramps. Which is no surprise. Boof, 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 boof. Got someone following me behind now. Go on, go up the other bit. Bug off. Okay, we're inside the campers, chaps. It's Tim Wagstaff speaking, but on the camera now, we got some historic people here.
Not too historic.
Colin Russell and Deborah Kerby, both of us worked on Auf Wiedersehen Pet back in the day, and they're here today to come round with me and tell us some stories. So what did you do, Colin? For fans that wanted the gathering, what did you do?
I was a rigger.
A rigger?
On the mobile recording unit. I drove the van, did the cables and did all the other stuff, and dollies and tracks and stuff like that. And Deborah was the
assistant designer.
Ah. All the plans.
Yeah, well, a bit more than just the plans. Plans, elevations, and charting up locations, building the studio sets.
Everything you saw, backgrounds, everything around, Deborah had her eye on.
Right, Barley Mow.
The Barley Mow, we even got the drawing with it to Deborah to prove it.
The cross key set.
Yep, all of those, yeah.
Ali's Villa.
Yep, everything was in the studio. Here,
yeah. Yeah. So, this. It was about 29 years ago, and this brings back a lot of memories. It's changed a little bit, but it's basically the same. What is the same is this shirt. This is what I used to wear then, and I can still get into it.
So that's good.
The only thing that's changed is the glasses, but the rest is the same. And the wrinkles, yeah. Hey, I'm here. I'm happy with that. So I'm still alive. Some aren't, yeah. So we're very pleased, I think, to just come and have a little look around and
just see relive the old memories.
See how it's changed and tell you how it's changed.
See the differences.
Yeah.
Right, we'll see you soon.
Let's have a look. Let's go and have a look.
So this is all different.
It is. We used to come out that door, around the corner, into the sports and social club.
Through the side that there, didn't
we? So that was the sports and social.
Yeah. Yeah. Nice.
Chairs.
Very, very
soon. Costa. Right, chaps.
Follow us.
We're on.
Right.
On the head motion cam, chaps.
This is the main corridor down to the studios. Hasn't changed a bit.
Not a bit. I haven't plastered it yet.
We've still got the statue.
Statue.
It's still there. It's still there.
Oh, this is the front of the site. It's been there.
Ah.
This came up with us, yeah.
The site.
Yeah.
That was a new addition, that bit. That's the Belgrano.
They still call it the Belgrano.
C1, up to C1 and all B floors now, the university name it has.
There we go. It's a dinosaur attacking it.
Yeah. We actually have student walls here, and all the students come and they put stuff like that in.
Excellent.
Ah, that's where Anglo American is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ah.
We'll take you out there in a bit.
Yeah.
Right.
There we
go. Come on. Come on. Off the carpet.
So you can go into Studio 7 if you want. I don't think anyone's in there now, just getting set up.
That's where Auf Wiedersehen was done, isn't it?
This is sort of the crossroads of the place.
Okay.
And you can see each end of the building.
It's quiet here.
Is the restaurant still up there?
Do you have a restaurant? Restaurant's up there, yeah.
Up there. And down there was makeup, wardrobe.
Studio 8.
And Studio 8 down there.
It's massive, isn't it?
Studio 7 is...
Have you been here before, Tim?
Huh?
Have you been here before?
No.
Oh, okay.
If you look in Studio 7, it's exactly the same as what it was.
Oh, wow.
All the lights are up there still.
What are
the
lights
put
on?
Whoa.
Yeah.
Good God. Help.
Sorry.
Yeah, it's just a film company having a quick look.
We'll go away
so
tonight.
This This was the light entertainment studio, but occasionally used for drama. So it's a big light entertainment studio.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah. Look at all that above.
And there's a big audience seating there that comes out. The audience seating comes right out.
Ah, oh, I've seen similar to this at Teddington.
Yeah.
I've been down to see.
So they used to do shows like Supermarket Sweep, Price is Right.
Oh, yeah.
Blockbusters, all the big LE shows used to be done here.
Ah.
Yeah. And the studio's unique because it's got a sunken trough around the edge so you can get white infinity.
My God.
Can put a white sight, stretch your white sight around, and then there's a big sort of 6-foot trench all the way around, and you can light it out so it just becomes completely white infinity.
Gee.
Yeah. So not every studio's got one of those. If they have, it's great.
Yeah.
I mean, when it was built, it was like, well, not so much now, obviously.
Well, yeah, I suppose it's a bit older.
When all those lights come down, the whole lot just come down right to the floor to set the lights, and then they go back up over each particular set.
Jeez.
Yeah.
Still all work.
Do they?
Mm.
I thought they pulled all the plugs when they cut all the plugs when it was.
The tech guys use it.
Do they?
When we have student balls here and they put lights in.
Of course, yeah.
All the way around. Yeah. And put it back up.
Yeah.
God, look at all that. All them seats.
Still use the seating.
Do they? Yeah, for complexes, yeah.
Well, they are then, chaps, eh? Studio 7.
Two big dance competitions a year and they're 500 years in.
It seems all blacked out.
Still got
the
gallery.
Jesus.
I mean,
the gallery.
Control room. Studio 6 has made into a gym now. Is it? Yeah. Yeah, the control room. So it's pretty big. It's a big space. Yeah. Studio 6 itself is archiving.
That lot comes out to about here.
Do you
ever use the seats?
Yeah.
Here's your main corridor back out to the hallway there.
Jesus. You see the gallery?
Yeah.
Oh,
wow. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
What
was
that for?
Thank you, mate.
I thought this would all be like rooms and coffee bars.
Oh, lighting gallery.
Lighting gallery.
That's where the lighting director would sit. There'd be a bank of screens there.
Right.
Yeah, the lighting gallery. And then the directors would all sit in here.
And they could see through the glass, so they could look through and see each other.
Ah.
So it's just directors and the next one along the sound.
Yeah.
Bloody hell. It's amazing how much is still,
It could easily be put back and used quite easily.
Yeah.
Yeah. Frankie Held.
A few people have been down and looked at the studio.
Have they?
It's a gift, isn't it?
I just don't think the people that are in charge of it know what to charge and how to run it.
Yeah. So. It would take a bit of getting hold of a scrub to make them market it and do it.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Paul Bennett's been down a few times from Yorkshire.
Oh,
is he? Can I look in there? Is that 6?
That's just a store cupboard. That used to go to Studio 6.
6
been knocked all out now.
Studio 6 was just a little news studio.
By local news.
Yeah, there should be a bit of blockbusters in there, but it's been bricked up. Yeah.
Okay. Oh, bloody hell.
Pond's still there from Crossroad. Oh no, it's been took out now. That was still there not long ago, that went.
I think
my God.
Debbie hates being photographed.
Come on.
Changing rooms and locker. Yeah, yeah. That's
dressing rooms. One of the 35 dressing rooms is still there.
I got it.
Yeah. Dermatologist.
It's good, this chap, isn't it? Good. This building's massive. Bloody long.
Tim, this was the wardrobe department.
This was wardrobe?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can have a look in.
That was the wardrobe office and rooms.
Yeah,
that
was all the washing room.
That's all office space.
Yeah, that was where they used to get.
But that was an open area.
Yeah, workshops and things.
Sort of. Make the costumes.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's just a boring office now. Exciting.
It's not good. Hell of a change from the past.
It's not that different, It's not that different.
Is it not?
No. This is the same. This is the very spot where I walked along here, and Robert Maxwell was walking past here with a smile on his face.
Robert Maxwell,
who owned the place at the time.
Oh, did he?
Yeah, what would happen to him?
Yes.
You can go, there's no to see in there. Studio 11 is full of push bikes, but spot the IRR.
So it was Studio 8?
Studio 8, we can't go in because it's manuscripts. Studio. Yeah, but we can't go in Studio 8.
Oh, 11's the little room around the corner.
11, yeah.
Ah. We won't go in, I'll get you into trouble.
8's where the exam's going on?
No, it's just all manuscripts, all valuable documents.
Oh,
okay.
Oh, was that the sound studio?
Yeah.
No, that was the sound studio, music studio. Used to be all fully... Well, a huge music studio, basically.
Okay.
And no, it's a bike shed.
That's a bike shed.
Well, it's...
God, look at that.
It's the University of IRR.
Oh, right.
Well, it's a bike shed.
It's a bike shed.
Hey, it's soundproof. It's probably the only soundproof bike shed.
Oh, I used to have a little band, jazz band, and we used to rehearse in here.
Good, good.
There you go. Jazz band.
Jesus.
Right.
God, look at all them. It's like walking into Depot of Alfreds or something, eh?
It was all carpeted and, screens and everything like that. It was a fantastic music studio.
There's no one going to crack my lens, is there? Okay. That's my job.
It was a fantastic music studio.
How long has that been in there?
That's
the
Crossroads, that was.
Ah, Crossroads.
It was a beautiful music studio.
Was this the kitchen?
Really
it was.
It's a bike shed.
I know.
And then it went out to this, didn't it?
It's our little band rehearsing here on Thursday nights.
So if you walk through here, you can go down...
It's just a sneak in,
It's still up from Crossroads.
You can hear the acoustic deadness already.
There was a carpet, wasn't it, and everything, yeah.
Jeez.
You can't afford to hire a bike. And then out there, it's through into the dock area.
Oh, that's a docking.
Yeah, it's good.
Yeah, okay.
Keep you studying. Okay.
Come this way. Wow.
Oh, beautiful.
Wow. Oh, now this is the fallback area. This has not changed.
This is where all sets for, stores.
Yeah, oh, okay. Yeah.
Still got a bagel barrow.
Have a look that way.
Put stored on these barrows, and then that big dock door there. The lorries used to unload there.
Okay.
And then the carpenter's workshop was down there.
This was the construction shop.
Ah, so Barley Mow could have been made down here, sort of thing.
Yeah.
And the cross keys and...
A lot of the big sets were actually built down in London.
Ah, okay.
This isn't actually that big.
And then brought up here on the Lowick.
Yeah, this isn't a very big workshop.
Jeez.
This was construction here and then painters were the other end.
Norman the foreman didn't have time to do oak.
There you have it.
Oh, God. It's pretty massive, isn't it, the place as a whole? I didn't realise.
So little benches and everything, workshop benches and all that sort of stuff.
So it really wasn't very far for some of the scenery made.
Yeah, it's just straight through a couple of hallways and you're there, aren't you?
Straight through and across here.
Yeah. And special effects was next door and Rachel next door.
So let's go back this way.
God, it's all coming back.
No. Mechanical
workshop.
It was.
Oh, yeah, mechanical workshop.
Jesus.
And then props are
still there. Props are still there. Still got props all in it. Lakeside use it.
That door down there.
Yes.
Props.
Props.
Fresh spectrum drapes are down there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I got it.
This is studio...
That's the Doctor Who Studio 8.
8?
Yeah. Ah, okay.
Get the height. Get the height.
My God, yeah, just a bit.
There's the height.
Jeez.
Same here.
Oh, yes. I've got you. Oh, there we go.
Hey, remember we did? I worked on Boone, and that was the sign that we did.
I've got to disturb my camera smoothness here. There we go.
That was Boone after or before? I mean, is
it? After. It was after one.
Was it after?
88. Yeah, Boone was 86 to 95.
Yeah.
We got it in 88. It came from Birmingham. It was done on film in Birmingham.
And I remember I was put on it for about, oh, God. I got married to get off it. I was so fed up with it. I thought, if I get married, and then I've got to get off the show. because I was set to be on it for another series, and it was just, oh god, the scripts were so crap.
Were they? Didn't like them?
They were just predictable crap.
Oh. I don't think it was too bad.
Did you get that sign to get in your
car? Yeah.
Well, you'd love that, wouldn't you?
Well, depends how to look at theft around the university. Shame they haven't got the old Barley Mow sign, that'll be on.
There might be some older avenues.
Yeah.
Lakeside.
University.
The missus said to me when I was coming down, she says, oh, is it still set up for Auf Wiedersehen? I says, I'd hardly doubt it.
You've got the steps for Sam.
Oh, okay.
This is all tech guy stuff.
Tech guy stuff, yeah.
There's
some steps for upstairs.
Tech guys is in that used to be opposite over the road?
It's for the university, setting all of the things
up. Oh, I was going to say.
Are there all props up there still?
Yeah, yeah, you can look straight through your screen.
Okay, let's go. So this is prop store.
But only a few. This was desperation prop stores.
Oh, okay.
But all of it was hired from London. Big, massive prop stores down in there, like Superhire and A&M and Newman's. But this was if you were desperate and you needed just something for free to put on the set.
Oh, right.
Yeah. Not an umbrella or any old stuff.
Gee. So there could be some treasures in there, possibly.
Possibly, but you'd have to root through it, yeah. treasures.
Ah. Oh. A lot of people do wonder what happened to that Barley Mow sign and all the rest of it. Oh, yeah.
It'll be in there somewhere.
Have you spoken to Wayne at Anglo?
Yes.
Yeah. What's happened to all the vehicles? The vans?
He did tell me
BMW,
that the BMW was sold to a lady in Ashbourne and she gave him a fraudulent banker's draft. Says in the end, he says they never saw the car again. He says in the end they did get the money, but it went to Ashbourne. He never saw the car. He said Barry's van was always around Nottingham, which many a Nottingham person can vouch for, because it was always hovering about with a for sale in the window for like $2,500 or something, more than what it was at the time. And that sort of slowly disappeared. The camper van, the CBE 210K, was always off the ring road down towards the Futurist, and it just disappeared one day.
That must still be going there.
It must be, because they go forever.
Yeah,
but he did tell me on Barry's van they used to pour salt water over it quite often to make it look a bit more distressed. And worn out and, you know, old and knackered sort of thing.
No one then had any idea that people would want them now.
Well, that's the thing, yeah. It was just a vehicle, wasn't it?
We had no idea. It's just another prop hire vehicle.
Yeah. Hmm.
End of the series, get rid, you know.
Yeah. But when I pulled up to him 2 weeks ago, there was an old Capri there and an old like half a daily Jag.
Yeah.
And I was like, yeah, we've got a lot on, mate. We're doing Hollyoaks, we're doing this, we're doing that. I was like, bloody hell.
Yeah.
And I phoned him yesterday. He says, oh, bloody hell, mate, it's all go down here. I says, well, I'll be down tomorrow. So if you want me to go away, just give us a hand signal, but not that one. And he says, no, and I've been to see him today. That's when I pulled back out and I saw you, and I parked up down the road.
Catch up with him in a minute, hopefully.
But yeah. Old memories, Debs.
Old memories.
There you go. You're coming on, mate. Do you want, this is a chap right, showing us about. Look, just give us a wave. There you go. This chap's he's coming today. He's like, bloody hell, I'm going to slip my wrist at the end of this. But yeah, the old prop store chaps. All these bloody places that are so familiar to you, yet so new to me, even though we're into studio anymore.
That used to be Crossroads, didn't it?
That was
Crossroads, one of the sets in Crossroads.
Oh, dear.
Oh, I'd left there then.
I left
in 99.
Oh, dear. When did this place stop functioning? 2006 and 7, wasn't it?
10 years ago.
Can we go upstairs to the design office?
See what is design? That's all.
There you go, chaps, your boon sign.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We'll come back down this way.
Okay.
Look at the beds.
Oh, yeah. Where's the old bike store in there?
The old store.
Thank you.
Same, yeah. Why do you only have a cop who looks there?
Oh god. Like a big maze.
Oh, this one.
Yeah. There
you go.
Well, I used to use this first.
Thank you, Colin. Thanks, Deb.
Down here, and newsrooms
yeah.
Are all up here.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah, that was an edit suite in there.
Yeah.
Oh.
An old newsroom.
Yeah.
An edit suite.
This is what it is now, a program team meeting room. But. Okay. When I did the Auf Wiedersehen video, yeah.
This is where you edited
this
it?
This was ENG3, and this was the edit suite in here. Where this desk is,
ta-da!
Was a built-in edit suite with monitors, and that was like a little sound dub recording studio behind, just for dubbing on.
My God.
We never used that, but I did the edit here.
Gee.
Yeah.
And that's how it all got made?
Yeah.
Well, fans would have seen it at the gathering. Definitely,
yeah.
It was done in there.
Right.
Oh, not the camp there yet.
This was actually the newsroom, yeah. News area, all of this.
Oh, this was newsrooms.
Local news, yeah.
East Midlands, Central News, yeah.
This is all the NM on it.
Yeah. Whole technical area, in the centre, all the broadcasting gear, engineers, all in there.
Jeez.
Did have a kitchen.
It's less impressive now, isn't it?
I think it's us.
A bit drab.
Dull, it's
drab and dull.
It's
what happens to nostalgia.
It's quite a sort of upbeat, sort of modern place. Now, wow. Well,
can you remember the old garden? Well, once a garden, it's a garden now. If you just look down there.
Garden?
It just used to be open tarmac, didn't it, if you remember, fire road.
It's just a corridor. It's just a corridor. This was always a distinct part of the building, too.
Right.
Fire tarmac, fire road, wasn't
it? That's really nice. That's the old from Blockbusters.
That's
from Blockbusters?
You remember there used to be those panels on Blockbusters?
Oh,
they used to be all over here, actually, but they've just kept one.
No, there's one more.
Is there?
I don't know what that one is.
Polystyrene, made to look like stone.
Yeah.
Dun, 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 dun. That's really old. Yeah, anyway, let's go to my design office.
Oh, a design office.
Yeah.
Jeez, it's just crammed full of bloody... It's a little bit of history, isn't it?
This was a technical area, design and maintenance.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, Phil Wadsley, I can't help. Gush, Lumbrough.
This is actually still is alive at this time.
BT Library. Boring little place, then.
No, I'm
being
really horrible.
That's all office-sized.
Well,
the old sports and social
club
used to be up there.
Yeah.
Used to be there.
What is it now?
Don't know.
Something to do with IT.
You used to get drunk up there.
So
there's
no bar.
You used to get drunk.
No bar. There's no bar.
So there was a bar and you used to get drunk up there? Well,
yes. That's why they had steps to test it.
So you could fall down them at the end?
Just can have a look if you want.
Have a look.
Okay.
Mine's a gin and tonic.
Plenty of us staggered out here.
This was the bar.
This was a bar.
Yeah, straight from there.
Yeah.
It's gone.
This was the bar here, yeah. No, okay.
In this space.
My God.
We're having a meeting, so I think we should.
We've been boxed in now.
We'll go away.
No, you've got.
It's a big open bar, it's really nice. And it was then moved down next to reception. And the reason it moved, because they didn't want people getting drunk on the premises, so they made the entrance to the bar right next to reception. So it was a separate entrance, so people could be seen leaving reception, going into the bar. Whereas just here, you could just slip in.
You slip it, yeah.
Yeah.
On the crafty.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, the Auf Wiedersehen Pass cast to get drunk in there.
They wouldn't though, because the bar didn't change for a long time. That would have been the original bar when our Wiedersehen Pet was done, yeah.
Ah.
Yeah.
Jimmy and all the rest.
Now, where I used to work.
Yeah.
Just stand there.
Was in here.
Good old days.
Yeah, chaps, nice long corridor again. Look, that's what this building is, long corridors.
My office was here.
Was it? This was Deb's office.
That hasn't changed.
It's completely the same.
Same glass how it was.
Yeah, the same glass, but you'd go in here and it
wasn't. No one in there, is it?
Just down there. So all the drawings were done just down there against one of those windows. It was all partitions.
Okay.
Yeah.
This is good. Oh!
Next time her office was nearest to the bar. Yeah. Nobody noticed that. No,
closer to the bar. Yeah. So I could just sneak away. Just go to the toilet, G&T.
Yeah. So,
you want to go next, Hangler?
Could we go back to the middle and then out to it?
Where the boon security was, where the sign was and the props.
So pick it up in the middle and then on the way up to the yard, and then we sort of covered it.
I knew I'd get that. There we go.
Okay.
Yeah, this was quite vibrant, it's just a bit...
Yeah, just a bit dull in there.
Dull.
It's not up to Deb's standard. Should be like the Barley Mow.
No, but it was all brand new then, you see.
Ah.
Now this was built in the 1980s.
Yes.
83. So it was all brand new.
They were still building when we arrived.
Yeah.
I've got a question for you. This is basically from an episode, but on one of the start episodes of Series 2, Kevin Waitley's working on a building site when he gets a message saying, Neville, phone, and he goes to find out his missus is giving birth. At the back here.
No. Gamston.
Because there's a building just down Lenton Lane that matches it.
By the Nottingham Knight at the back there, by the Apple Tree Pub, what is now.
Oh no, that's one of them, but this is the one where he's on the site and he gets the phone call.
Oh.
And there's a building just down Lenton Lane here. You go over the bridge and go down. Because it was being built in the 80s.
Yeah.
And it's one of the locations I tracked down.
Yeah.
But it's actually had changes to it now. The front's been knocked off and the front land's been sold off as units. But yeah, one, as you remember, Colin, was Lanmere Lane. It used to be an old landfill.
Yes.
And they were building on it when he's looking for work on the scene. That's where that blue Citroen estate is in the background parked up.
That's it.
That was one of the crew cars, wasn't it?
I'll show you where we used to park. Are
you having fun, Debs?
It's just weird. It's like something from a nightmare. I feel like I'm in some sort of nightmare dream.
Because you're back in this building.
Yeah, it's really odd, actually.
Is it?
Just weird.
Names in the credits, though, Dan.
Let's go to the canteen.
Canteen's exactly the same.
Is it?
Yeah. It's just got, in fact, some of the old furniture, the red chairs, are still there.
Have they put a new ceiling? Because this was
the ceiling's
all been
dropped.
I was going to say, it was never this kind of...
Was it never this low?
No, there was higher.
Uh-huh.
The lighting's just so terrible. Yeah. I thought
they're
saving money by having
real lights
on. Is that
you, Ivan? No.
Print room.
Medical? No,
it was
medical.
Medical
centre.
Medical?
Print room.
Print room was there, okay.
Where you get your... Wait, look, I've got my prints here. Prints. They'll all be printed in there.
Is the pan still here?
Oh.
No, that's my office now, actually.
Oh. Is it?
I'm dumped in there.
The medical room?
Yeah. Well, just inside, I've got a little office in there.
Oh, dear.
And there were pictures on the walls of productions and things, yeah. Nice photos.
Yeah.
That was
university things. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah,
that's sort of what they've done. Yeah, fair enough.
Well, that was the
that
door.
Yeah.
I went to
that
door about
5 million
times.
Ah, that was the way to the office.
Yeah.
Okay.
Tell the girls over there and get to sort the rubbish.
Okay, Morgan. Can I ask a favour?
Yeah.
The canteen.
Can I have a cake?
Hey. He's filming for Auf Wiedersehen Pet.
Are you?
Yeah.
They, these two used to work at Central Studios years ago.
You can have a cake for me.
No,
do you want one?
Free. Well, they're naughty, no.
You can have one, because I'm just going to...
Really?
Sure. Would you like one?
Yes, please.
You sure you don't want one?
You might talk me into it.
Let me get you a cake.
Look at this, nicking the cakes.
Oh, that's really
fine. Oh. Can I have a cake? It could be a celebration cake.
Yeah.
Ah.
After
30
years.
Oh, are you sure?
Yeah.
Who are they for?
I'm just taking them down to Costco to see if there's all there.
Which was the old bar. Oh,
really?
Ah.
Oh, thanks.
Thank you.
No problem.
Pretty Costco to get everywhere, don't
they? So has it changed a lot then since you've...
It just seems a bit sort of... duller. Duller.
Yeah, it is.
We were here with brand new, you see. It was all a bit sparkly.
So where do you work now then?
I'm self-employed. I teach at Trent actually. And I'm
oh right, are you still, well, so you still do any film working for...
I don't know, I do interior design now. Yeah.
I work in Grantham. I'm sorry. Would you like a cake?
No, thank you. No, you can see I've had enough already. Yeah.
Yum.
I'm not bothering to ask you.
What food did you want?
Right, I need some more tables and chairs in the restaurant.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, there's just the camera. They had a lovely ceiling in here. There's a lovely ceiling.
That good cake?
That is so good.
Oh, look at that.
Look at the cream.
Right to the camera, there you go.
Oh.
Like an eclair cream, is it? Like that sort of cream.
Great ceiling.
Oh, here we go.
It was the best designed part of the place, actually, this.
Remind me tomorrow then, I'll sort it.
Ah. So this is where... Oh, okay, I can see where we are now. Main reception's up there.
Yeah.
Very nice cake.
You know all those blockbusters things, yeah. Tim? They're all on here, one in each panel.
Oh, okay, let me stand back and grab that. There we are, chap. This is the bad bit, I'm afraid, for the camera. See all that out there? Paint display. Bloody rip-off, man. It is. £5 for 3 hours.
It's free an hour, Dave.
I know. Makes you sick, doesn't it?
That's a nice view. Lovely view.
When we moved here, started here, the trees weren't grown at all. They were just twigs.
Ah.
And the grass was laid in front of
just
my
sort
eyes.
Of plonked in the soil, and that's how you saw them.
Just up there, one of those windows up there.
Yeah. Oh, dear. So they're basically chaps, as of these days, there's your canteen. Quite a nice place, this. You got any jobs going, mate? I'd love to work in this building. I've done security 10 years ago, though. So, at some point...
Yes?
Would we have, I don't know, say, Auf Wiedersehen cast, the upper hand cast, Price is Right? Would we have people in here eating, or would they be private and keep themselves to themselves?
Here.
They'd all come in here and have...
Yeah.
You'd have a chat with them, would you?
What about chat?
Boon cast.
Yeah, everybody come here, wouldn't they? Yeah, it was just a canteen. Yeah. Unless you're out filming, then if you're out filming, there's obviously...
Well, yeah, on location.
On location,
yes.
Location caterers, yeah.
Lunchtime would be really busy.
Yeah.
They're all compiling in, it's a real buzz, busy canteen.
But do you know what was really funny? Was that people only used to sit in certain areas, didn't they? So
yeah.
All construction and painters used to sit along
yeah.
there.
Yeah.
Right, okay.
They sat there all day, then whenever time...
They sit there all day.
Yeah. Riggers was here, we went there, because we weren't quite there, but we were almost, so we're on the end.
Okay.
Cameras and sound went over here.
I mean, no, there was, you could sit where you liked, it's just that that's where people
Yeah,
sat.
It's just they sort of, like a high school, they sort of
yeah.
categorise themselves
yeah,
in a way.
It's the British class system.
Yes,
that
down
is
there was a bit low class. They were just the labourers and, the, you know, like, you know, they were, you would never sit there. You would never sit there. If
you're not
going
there.
If you're a cameraman, oh God, you wouldn't sit over there, would you? No chance. It was a real hierarchy, wasn't there?
Oh,
yeah, a real hierarchy.
Except when it came to the rap.
Unwritten hierarchy.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Or the construction party at Christmas, then everyone's friends, aren't they? Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Remember that? Mm. Yeah.
Still do one about it now, every Christmas party. Yeah. 3 day for 12 till 12.
How long have you been here for a camp? How long have you been around this building?
Altogether, it's going to be 25 years.
Gordon Bennett, man.
Yeah,
same. Jeez.
The lucky one.
So, like Colin and Deborah, you know, many changes and people's faces probably come and gone, eh?
You still see people come in.
You're looking. Do you not remember Debs?
Yeah, immediately, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. You remember Colin? You remember him then?
I remember immediately.
I can't remember that chap.
It was on the road.
He probably didn't work for Elton.
Do you remember Will? Do you remember Will Davis?
Yeah,
is that name?
Will, yeah.
It's an ugly room.
Barry Stevenson, Jerry Elms.
But Will, yeah, I know Will.
Yeah. He's just up the road, isn't he, Tollerton?
Yeah.
Still see some of the scene lads, Mark Jones and people like that.
I see him on Facebook, yeah.
Yeah. So, staff old and sort of new, you still sort of know if each other and have an idea where you are, what jobs are doing there.
Well, in a way.
Yeah.
They have a 2-year reunion.
Should I film that? Look. That is the around the pool in Spain.
Oh, there we go. Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So that's me.
Yeah. Yeah.
There's Deborah.
Yeah. Deborah.
That's me.
That's Roger Bamford.
There you go.
Okay. Yeah.
Jimmy Nail.
Yep. Yeah.
Moxie.
Neville.
Kevin.
Kevin. Yeah.
Kevin Waitley.
Who else is there? Bomber.
Bomber, yeah.
Wayne.
Oh dear.
Well, you said the animal room, didn't you? We had a big punch bag in.
Jerry Elms.
Yeah.
Jerry the... is that Jerry?
Jerry Elms.
Jerry Elms, cameraman.
There he is.
Vicky Roberts,
is he, yeah.
PA.
Yeah.
He was wardrobe. Tony.
Yeah.
Oh dear.
PA.
And that's CJ
Lindsay.
On makeup.
CJ, she got married last week, didn't she?
I took the photo. I was her best man. No, I was her fella's best man.
Really?
Yes. I know.
Random.
We were friends.
Oh, wow.
Well, there he is. There's a... Is that Tim Ealy?
Yep.
Yep.
Yep, that'll be him, yeah. You can take a shot of us.
Yeah.
So that's everybody. That was the whole cast and crew.
Where's Tim Sport? There he is.
That's the producer. What's his name?
Martin McKeon's.
That's it, yeah.
Oh, yeah, I know that name.
Yeah.
Roger Bamford in the green T-shirt.
And this guy in the shades at the end was a local Spanish guy. He was like the... he used to do security at night.
Mm-hmm.
And see his brown belt? he had a little gun. He used to keep in the leather holster.
Oh, aye. He used to keep a gun?
Yeah. They do in Spain.
Is that Anglo-American? Was he Anglo?
No. That was...
That was Caterers.
Caterers.
Oh, that's John Taylor. He died, didn't he? He died.
I'm going to his funeral tomorrow.
He's lovely
John
man.
John Taylor.
Your mate. Yeah.
My mate, yeah. And, what's his name?
He was sound, Paul.
Take five catering.
This chap looks like the one in the video that does a little
sort of
act on the
Peter.
Spanish filming.
Peter Smith.
Yeah.
Peter Smith, he was a first assistant director. Yeah.
So he looks familiar.
Yeah. Will Davis.
Will, who was here?
Infamous Will Davis.
Want to drop the radio in the sea?
That's right, yeah.
Yeah.
Cameraman.
And it's still
cameraman.
There.
I bet it is.
David McDonald, first assistant director.
Yep.
Bloody hell.
Oh, there.
Bloody hell.
Happy days.
That's good, that. All these pictures.
Do you want to see any more or not? There's Roger Bamford at the end of filming in Spain.
There we go, Roger Bamford, yep. I bet that was refreshing.
Oh, that's on the one, that's on the Sanssouci. I bet you've seen these.
The real name of that is the Five Angels.
Was it?
Yeah.
It's Sanssouci.
There you go.
Oh, filming on the Sanssouci, I think.
Oh, yeah, in the sea.
Yep. That's Roger there, Roger Bamford.
Oh, I just see him, yeah.
And that was at the villa. Will Davis.
Yeah. Will Davis.
Richard Lindsay, David McDonald, Vicky Roberts.
Jeez.
There you go.
And back to Rog. He's a nice bloke, Rog. No matter what the convention, he's really nice.
Rolling?
Yes.
Are you rolling? As if they roll these days. we're back in the scene dot kit. This is the scene dot, right in the middle of things. Construction shop that side, studios that side, and we head outside.
The
this is
see,
the main entrance.
So you see these
splodges
on the wall down here, coloured
splodges? I see them, in the distance.
Mad Fruit, was it?
I worked on a programme called Mad Fruit, and it was a kids' slapstick games sort of programme. and I had all those painted on the wall. Uh-huh. There's a few games out here.
Oh, there you go.
You've never seen so much gunge all over
there. It was one of those
gunge. Oh, is it one of them? Yeah.
This was type programme, yeah.
And there's all the splats on the wall. There you go, still there.
That's a paint shop down there.
Was that a paint shop?
Paint shop, yeah.
My God. It goes on and on, doesn't it?
Oh, that's where the heavy gang used to live, didn't they?
Yeah.
The heavy guys.
The heavy gang?
Yeah.
They were the guys who used to... Heavy gang, they used to build... Lift heavy stuff.
They were scene hands.
No, they weren't.
Scene hands.
It was a joke.
There was 10 of them.
They used to sit in there doing bugger all.
All day. God.
And you go and you say, could you think you move that? And you go, well, we might do.
And then they start at 4 o'clock, get paid double time.
Yeah?
And who was the boss?
John Revel.
Their boss. Jimmy
Reardon. Jim Reardon.
Who was in charge of John Revel? Jimmy Reardon.
And it was in there, they've been there, was it? So they've been there waiting to be asked to move scenes.
Yeah. No, they were fine. They used to shift all the scenery that used to come in here, off, say, from outside on lorries.
Yes.
The lorry would stop here, and they'd offload it, and they'd either go onto trucks or straight to the studio. So that was their bit. There were other scene hands allocated to a programme that put it up and did things in studio. Yeah. So this was the outside.
This was sort of deliveries and incoming.
Yeah.
And they'd have chaps set up in the studio.
They were the scenery outside crew, colloquially known as the heavy gang.
I thought
gang.
That's what they were called. No. Just official name.
What, the heavy gang?
Well, they were just sort of heavy gang.
Got a pair of gloves.
Well, they never seemed to do any work. They just had a right old doss of a time, didn't they? They're all on megabucks.
In their day.
Yeah?
Yeah, megabucks in those days, yeah.
There you go. But there you go. This is the main door. Construction, studios, yard.
And this is the yard.
Ah, Anglo. Yeah, I see where I am there. I thought it was coming out of another angle, but I'm not.
No.
All the way up.
Over here,
huh? What have we got here?
Goods inwards, wasn't it, here? Goods inwards.
This Goods is in. Where we used to keep our van. The blue van. Binoculars.
Our
VW van used to live in here.
And it's not there now.
It's a storage room now. And we used to keep stuff in there. Then gradually, later on, we moved over there and got our own place. This is where we used to keep stuff. We had our van there and parked the Citroen in front.
Ah, okay. I can see Wayne and Dave.
I see
you. Dave on the right, Wayne on the left there, black shirt.
No, he's choked. That's his dad.
Is
I'll
it?
Leave you to it then, shall I?
Oh, it is his dad.
Is that okay?
You don't need me.
Oh, we like you being with us.
Well, I've still got me
over there. It's nice to see you anyway.
Oh.
I'll see you later. Cheers.
I'll catch you on reception, mate, so I've got another camera there in my tripod.
All right, mate.
But I will want to get some shots of the outside of the building from a distance. All right.
Oh my God!
There you go, chaps, Anglo-American.
Oh, nice to see you.
Oh, dear, man.
15 years.
Here's your Anglo-American, chaps.
Interior design and do a bit of Trent. Trent
lecture there. Still local then?
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't really sort of drifted off into doing any sort of film work anywhere else or anything.
I'm all right with this on, Wayne. Should I knock it up? Yeah. All right. Well, Wayne's part of Anglo American. Worked on the vehicles series 2 of Auf Wiedersehen. You remember the camper van, Wayne?
I remember them all very well.
And Barry's van and Wayne's BMW.
Yeah, no, I can remember all the BMW. Yeah, the camper van, Barry's little van. Yeah, no, it seems like yesterday. Unfortunately, it was best part of 30 years ago.
Yeah. Yeah,
university just sort of forgotten about us, I think.
You shrunk the space.
No, well, I thought when ITV moved out, that probably, you know, the university would probably want to get rid of us, but they've been sort of, been dead happy for us to stay, so. Keep charging us plenty of rent, mind you, but that's probably why they're happy.
I bet they do, yeah. And you weren't located, I said to these, you wasn't located here at time of filming Auf Wiedersehen,
no,
was you?
No, we used to keep some of the vehicles we used to keep down here, but we used to have a garage on Ilkeston Road.
Yeah, as you said, yeah.
Not there anymore, is it?
No, that's gone. That's student accommodation.
That's it, yeah.
Down near Radford, actually, yeah.
Along with most of Nottingham, isn't it? It's sort of all of Nottingham is becoming the university, isn't it?
Business.
Yeah. It's the biggest employer in Nottingham, aren't they?
Are they really?
It's just getting bigger, isn't it?
Yeah. Something like about 12,000 people. What's it like? Is it close to
anything? Hey, look, an original sign.
Oh, an original sign?
An original sign, hey. Yeah. Hey, original.
Bloody hell.
Oh, so this is basically how it was then?
Yeah. This is real.
Yeah.
It's good it's next door, so I've never noticed it's here.
Transport, scenic services, stores good in, was that energy centre? Energy centre?
Yep.
It's a weird one, eh?
That place there, that literally is a power station.
Power station.
Oh, yeah?
Really?
Yeah, that is there, yeah. Oh. It supplies power back to the national grid.
Oh, bloody hell.
Has he got things
it's
on the roof?
It's got a massive generator in it. It's what, yeah, well, there's charge. No,
in there?
Yeah, yeah.
All right. Well, it's the boiler house.
Well, it does a lot, yeah. All underneath, the whole of the underneath is a massive water tank for the sprinkler system that's pre-pressurised.
Oh, right.
That holds tens of thousands of gallons of water for the whole sprinkler system, for the whole complex.
Wow.
And then above it, you've got all the air conditioning heating.
Hey. It's getting in the distance.
That's the same sign.
All right. Here he is. He's come back again. Guiding people around, now he's emptying the bins. Well, there you are then, chaps. Colin Russell, Deborah Kerby, this is Wayne. Is Wayne and Dave in Anglo America? That's Wayne. Picture of him online with Gary Holton. But yeah, it's a good look at this. So this is the old yard. And then in the distance, down here is like your restaurant where we've just been. It's good this, I don't mind being off camera when we've got all these stories. But yes, in this car park, chaps, I mean, we pulled up, as you saw on the camera. Bloody prices are mad on this car park, paying display. You think an admin part of a university, you think maybe, I don't know, it'd just be a normal car park, wouldn't you, I suppose? But there you go. And this just carries on all the way up. So I'm just trying to get as much as I can because it's not often that I'm going to be down here filming, to be honest. But all these chaps today with these stories, you see, this is what we want. Colin likes his camera look, which I can understand. Sort of like a little reunion for them. Names remembered, people remembered. And yeah, as he says, original sign. This is how it was when Central was Central. Okay. Alright, chaps. That just proves it's used, that's all.
It's definitely used.
Yeah,
it's like a tip.
It hasn't changed a bit.
There's just more mess in it.
Well, they are, chap. This is your Anglo-American office these days, chap. Look at all these pictures, eh? This says it all. I mean, the play is a bomb site, but it doesn't matter.
Anyway.
Hey, I'd say it's bomb site, you can't.
No, it's used, it's good. It's good.
Tales of Sherwood. I've still got the sweatshirt. It was the best sweatshirt they ever gave us.
That was...
That's Windsor Davis.
That's Frampton Hall.
That's him who was the Sergeant Major in Caravan, isn't it?
Freddie Starr, remember him?
Well, back then you didn't. You got really nice sweatshirts, t-shirts, jackets, all sorts of things.
Ken Boone, have it.
Nah, bugger all.
You're lucky now if you get paid.
Really?
Yes.
Once upon a time in the Midlands.
Oh, some of the smaller productions, you spend half the time chasing them for money. They're smaller films like that. They make
here we
stuff
go, look, there's a Michael Elphick.
Yeah.
There you go.
David Dacre, is Dacre still alive?
He is, yeah.
Is he?
Yeah.
You haven't seen him on anything?
I have to Google him.
I've not seen him on a TV programme for years.
Are you sure? I thought he'd passed.
Bridget Forsyth, she's still in quite a bit, isn't she, Bridget?
She did Still Open All Hours at Christmas, didn't she? She was the sister of one of the regular customers.
She's in loads of
the forgetful customer in Open All Hours, Mavis. She played her sister in the... They're doing the new series now, aren't they, up in Doncaster? Yeah, they're filming it.
Richard Harris there, that one.
Yes.
That's great. We didn't do that from here, that was done down south somewhere that we did that.
But the old Peter Sellers. Jeez.
Yeah, it was, yeah, definitely. Yeah, we didn't work on that one.
What's this explosion, Wayne?
That's Pete Practice.
Is it?
Yeah, when we did that, I think that was the most expensive hour of sort of just regular drama TV ever made when we shot that.
Jesus. So you come across Kevin Whateley a few times.
3 years before they made it.
Do you remember Outside Edge?
Yeah, brilliant programme.
Do you remember the BMW?
Yeah, I remember it really well. Because I borrowed one off...
Central logo.
Hang on.
I borrowed it off Sittner. And
listen to this.
Yeah.
BMW.
Let me...
Okay, it was a BMW 5 Series.
Yeah, it was a 5 Series BMW. They'd only been out for about 18 months.
Okay.
We got one on hire, which was, back then was about £35,000 car from the Sickness of Nottingham.
Ooh, pricey.
And then halfway through the series, they suddenly realised that there's a scene when the BMW gets blown up. But nobody had actually realised this when they actually cast virtually a brand new car in the role. So unfortunately, when somebody said, well, can't we just nip to the scrapyard and buy one, when it's only been out for 18 months, it's not...
Well, it's not going to really happen, is it?
I found one from a guy in Rotherham. It was 18 months old, and it had done 231,000 miles in 18 months. I still had to give about 7,000 quid for it, because it was only 18 months old. Yeah. Paint it the right colour, because it was gold, it had to be silver. So in the end, it was probably about 10 grand's worth, but the original one from Sickness was like a 35 grand car. And somewhere, there's a picture of it somewhere.
So, here. I think I remember this.
There you go. Standing next to it, that's the explosion of it blowing up.
Fantastic. My God.
There you go.
So that was the 18-month-old car?
Yeah.
Jeez. Outside edge, yeah, there you go.
There's always talks about just doing a little bit of fire of effect and this, that and the other. When they done that explosion, trust me, it was just a charred mess.
Do you remember the one, it was a BMW, and Dave was there, and it was, I forget the producer, and anyway, they wanted it to burn. The idea was it had to start burning, and the deal was, and Dave was going, don't damage it too much, just sort of the seats a bit, just to burn a bit in the middle, and that's it, and then cut, and we put it out, and then we can easily fix it.
It was that one.
Was it that?
It's that one.
And Dave was standing beside me, and he went, action. Special effects, all that, up it went. And then the flames were starting to lick up, and Dave's standing beside me going, oh no! stop! And it just went.
Nick Hurran was the director, wasn't it?
Nick Hurran
was the director on it. Michelle Book, I think, was producing
and
it.
And Nick was going, just keep it rolling. Looking great.
The special effects guy had turned up late.
George,
I can't remember who it was, but anyway, he had a bit of a tiff with Nick Curran.
Everybody had a tiff with him, didn't they?
And the special effects guy took umbrage, and he put extra. he said at the time,
it's about right.
So he put extra gear in the car when he blew the car up and set fire to it. That's why it ended up being such a fireball. Because he'd had a bollock in it. He did some other effects as well, I think, which Nick thought was a bit pony. It wasn't sort of dramatic enough. So it was like, well, this bloody one will be, So he shoved a lot of extra gear in it. So when he went up, he was like, shit. Yeah, wow, that's a bit dramatic.
It was great,
But because of that, there wasn't much left of the car, shall we say. There wasn't a lot worth salvaging.
Just a black, sooty mess.
Yeah, but it looked good.
And that was show business.
The other classic.
It was Boone, security van, top car park. And it was when they were doing Boone security. Remember when they set up this and doing the security business? And this van, they're supposed to be keeping tabs on, because a couple of these vans have been nobbled. And somebody basically blows the back doors off it. So we get this van, and they decide to go up the top, and they're going to have a demo. We had to buy a spare one for them to have a look at this special effects. And it was the guys from here that, you remember Mick?
Mick.
Was it Steve then, before he became an electrician? Did he used to help him? No, it was before Steve's time, but it was Mick and another guy. So we set it up on the top car park, and they put two like steel cans in the back of the floor, pointed at the back doors with whatever number, they have different numbers of charges. Yes. Anyway, all the crew's around this thing, you know, about 50 yards away to have a look at it, to watch it blow the back doors open. It detonates this thing, and it completely unrolls the whole body of the van. It's got a roof rack on it, which is about 500 yards up in the air. The back doors didn't come down for about a week. And Mick just turns around and goes, bloody hell, it's a good job I didn't put a number four in. It was the classic, I only meant to blow the bloody doors off. It's just, the whole roof was just peeled out like a baked bean can. There's none. It just laid out in one sheet of metal. Fantastic. The back doors have gone. And it was just like, and two big holes in the floor about this big where these two charges were. All the crew's deaf. Everybody's like completely deaf.
Explosions and explosives are very hard to control.
It was about five times more powerful than it needed to be.
Bloody hell. And that was on a Boone.
That was just practice, yeah. Yeah,
yeah.
The worst thing for a special effects
in those days.
That wasn't.
It's not to
buy a spare van or
tech. Yeah, well, they said with Series 2 Auf Wiedersehen, they had quite a hell of a budget. They had a massive budget compared to Series 1, I was always told, with Auf Wiedersehen.
There was more money for it.
Yeah, that's why probably Beethorpe Hall and all the other stately bloody places were involved in. Denton Manors, that's as private as you can get.
We worked on that for about 13 months.
Yeah.
Yeah. Auf Wiedersehen.
85 into 86.
Seems to be a long time that you still worked on it.
We came back from, in the autumn, wasn't it? We came back, we were in Spain September to... It was November when we got back. Then there's all the studio stuff going on into the next year. And then we'd been out all summer at Compton.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Beethorpe Hall.
Yeah.
There's Big Bass says to me, yes.
Beethorpe. Compton, yeah. Was it 13 or 15 episodes? 13.
Yeah.
If you're working,
these people know better than us.
Yeah, 13, yeah.
If you're working, if you're doing a 13 episode series now, you'd be lucky if you got 6 months to make it.
Yeah.
It was the same, but the turnaround on Boom was 11 days an episode.
Yeah.
Yeah.
11
yeah.
filming days an episode yeah. To get 50 odd minutes of footage.
My
you
God.
Yeah, 4 minutes a day. On
and that was definitely. Considered rushed.
11 days was rushed to get an hour episode.
That was considered going for it.
So our Vida's Own Pet would have been about the same, wouldn't it?
Times change is all I can say with that, really.
Oh yeah, that expects everything's
on
the go.
It's definitely not changed for the better, that's for sure.
Yeah?
It's nothing like it used to be.
It's more pressure, longer days.
Too many inexperienced crews, the main problem. You know, there's too many people work on it now and they just use
All interns, aren't they?
Yeah, just really young, inexperienced crew who all basically go and work for nothing. But a lot of it's just disorganised chaos because they just don't know what they're doing.
Get away with it.
Yeah.
Oh dear.
They just have the odd...
I've got a phone call about a week ago, 2 weeks ago from someone. Oh, I'm a producer doing a film up in Newark. I need a production designer. Can you come and work on it this weekend? I said, oh no, I said, this weekend? This was like Monday when he rang up.
Yeah.
I said, are you paying for this? He went, oh no, just expenses. I said, sorry, I can't help you. Bye-bye.
Bloody hell. I expect the world just for a quid, eh?
See nothing wrong with that. Try phoning a plumber up like that.
Yeah.
Can you come over my place and fix my boiler on Saturday? I'll pay you petrol.
They'll probably laugh.
It really annoys me, actually. It really annoys me.
Yeah. If I pay you an extra £100, do you think you can get here in the next fortnight?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have a look at it. I'm not sure about that.
I can agree with that. Yeah, I can agree with that.
It's the veneer of glamour in telly and that. There's an apparent glamour to it.
Yeah.
And that, for somehow turns something off in people's brains when it comes to common sense and earning a living.
It's like people with large amounts of money. That does the same thing, I think.
Well, there's just so many students now, you know, have just taken media studies. It's just become one of the most common degrees to take at university.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, I think something like about 500,000 people go on media studies degree each year. And there just isn't that number of vacancies or posts in the industry. So you just end up with a massive glut of spare people. They'll just end up working for next to nothing or nothing.
Yeah, just so they can be in that
just
industry.
So they can get in it and try and get a bit of experience.
Yeah.
And they get into it, they think they're going to get a bit of experience and go up the ladder. And all they do generally is once they get to a position where they start demanding half decent money, they get somebody else in who's free or a lot cheaper.
Yeah.
And it's
so
just
look, you can do that for so-and-so and you want this now, so they get rid of the higher one.
Yeah, the only people that have kept, you know, a reasonable standard is people... Yeah, at the top end camera people, because they can't really risk the cameraman being absolutely useless, or you're just going to end up with a pile of rubbish.
Yeah.
The stunt people are the best ones. They've just kept their own tight-knit little community. They don't allow any more than a certain number of stunt people. They keep it all in-house. Any stunt person who tries to undercut the price gets ostracised. So they've kept it the best paying job by country miles, the stunt fraternity.
Film game.
Yeah.
Fight very hard to keep the rate.
Yeah.
And anyone that's ringing round, any so-called producer ringing round and offering silly rates, send it round and say don't work for it.
Yeah, don't work for it.
I mean, I got one the other day. Supposedly an ITV producer, a production company, somebody in an office, ringing up, trying to get a grip to work on short notice and offering a 14-hour day plus travel.
How much do they pay for that?
Not the rate, but 14-hour day. It's not that's not only unfair, that's unsafe to the public. How do you work a 14-hour
day and then
travel to and from? How safe
it's
is that?
It's too much.
I mean, actually demanding people to do that is, to me, unethical. It's just,
well, they have to have certain tea breaks and lunches and times and all the rest now, don't they? I used to work at Newark at fixing laptops every day. We used to do 6 in the morning till 10 at night, and then say, oh, I want you back here at 6 next morning. But hang on a minute, we need a certain amount of sleep here. But, you know, there was bedding in at the time, but same sort of thing that you wanted.
Yeah, we're supposed to have an 11-hour break, aren't you, after a certain amount of hours.
Yeah.
No, we get it the same with, you know, what we do with camera tracking vehicles and low loads and stuff, which involve, as you say, driving to and driving back. Yeah, we're working, we're up on Vera today, which is Newcastle. So, you know, we went up last night, but they were like, oh, can you not travel in the morning? So we've got a 4-hour travel, might potentially be there 11, 12-hour day, and then a 4-hour travel back.
Is that Brenda Blessing?
Yeah,
she's working up there.
Yeah.
Will you see her?
I'm not personally. No, I've not been up. No,
but, I've seen her since we did Outside Edge.
Yeah,
she's done all right.
She's
looking good there.
Yeah. No, she's kept working.
Yeah, I think she's a very good actress.
Yeah, I know we did Barbara. She was quite funny in Barbara as well.
She was brilliant to watch working. It's a lot of actors just, you know, it's acting. But she had this where when it was action, it was.
Yeah,
you knew it was something special. You watched it.
Was that again, Gwen? Gwen. What's her name?
Brenda Blethyn.
Oh, but so when he said Barbara, I'm thinking Gwen Bloody Taylor for a minute.
Yeah, no, the actual programme, Bob.
Yeah, Barbara. Yeah.
Real, you know, there are.
I do remember the face.
Actors, and some are bloody good.
Yeah.
Like, well, Tim Spall, they always said that the Auf Wiedersehen lot. He was the best. Shame about Auf Wiedersehen. Just sad stories, isn't it?
We had one on top, didn't we, on peak practice? He's not new peak practice, God, no, he wasn't the best actor in the world.
Woodentop.
Yeah, he's calling Woodentop, I'm trying to remember his real name. He was the Liverpool with him.
Oh, Moxie, Christopher Fairbank.
Yeah, he was a good actor. No, he was a super actor.
Who's the other Liverpool in?
No, he did peak practice after Kevin Whateley left.
Oh, bloody hell, I know who he means. I can't think of the name there.
Yeah, went on.
Yeah, the same, I can't remember his name.
But anyway, I get muddled,
he was, yeah, SM of the crew, he's called the Wooden Top.
Can I take a picture of you just sitting in your office?
Tell me if you want. Yeah. I'm going to go all shy and get red on the
embarrassed. How old are you?
37.
37? Well, you're quite old.
Did you hear the camera? Did you hear that, Mr. Camera? You're quite old.
37.
How old are you, Deb?
I'm ever so old.
48, 49,
I could be your mother.
Nice.
I could be your mother.
My mum's 59.
Oh, no, I'm not as old as your mother.
She's 60 in Feb.
No, I'm not old, not that old.
That's right then.
We'll have to go down here, won't we?
God, this is really free. Free range. Here's the bike store.
That's the first soundproof bike shop
ever done.
what a waste of...
Oh, and chaps.
It's just
crap. You don't like it, do you?
Well, it just seems a bit
sad. I just wish I'd seen it before for comparison, to be honest.
It's just a bit more buzzy.
It was painted red, wasn't it?
Was it?
Yeah.
Yes, it was, and the floor was a bit... Really off, studio, wasn't it?
We can't see studio,
can we? No, I know, but this was...
Oh, because it's an archive.
There you go.
Can't do
anymore
because it's
full of stuff. Okay. It's alright, we've got permission, don't we?
So
I know it's all we've been
asked
for.
Studio
8.
Yes.
So if
I open the door, am I going to spoil something? Ask them if they've written the door and going or not.
Warning, have you checked if the alarm is unset?
Can you check with them? You need to go and see the actual studio.
Yes, can you explain?
Excuse me, sirs, is this alarm set or unset? We did want to look early, he said it was possible, but there was an exam at the time. So we just sort of come a bit later on, see if it's possible to have a look in.
You wonder who we are, don't you?
Yeah, I do, yeah.
We're filming for Auf Wiedersehen Pet website.
Rolling.
So this is the entrance to Studio 8, where a lot of it was filmed.
Okay.
Which is identical to Studio 7, which is what
we did see before, yes.
We're not allowed in here because this is now a manuscript store, which is temperature controlled, and the guys here are not happy about us going in case we...
We can come back with Ivan, but at the end of the day, we're not going to see much anyway, are we?
No.
Yeah, I suppose we could come back.
It's not going to look
anything like
nah. a studio. Well, here's the other one. We got a good idea of it, didn't we?
But being a studio,
yeah.
being sort of soundproof and temperature,
mm-hmm.
it's ideal for that.
Yeah.
Very ideal. And probably they've got a lot of magnetic stuff that needs storage, long-term storage, and it would be ideal in there.
So but behind them doors, that's where it was.
Yep.
So Jimmy and Gary.
Are you disappointed?
Huh?
Are you disappointed?
Not as such. I can understand the building being used these days, you know, and it's got its purposes with the converted offices and stuff. Yeah. But yeah, I mean, to see it would be nice, but it didn't. We've seen the other studio.
We're lucky.
So we know what it's like.
Is.
Yeah.
Lucky it's still here. So.
Yeah, but no, it's good. Outside, it's better than nothing at all. Debs is having a good time. Look at Deb, she's happy today. Look. At the fan gathering, she wasn't happy. She was.
I was.
I'm only messing. But yeah, Deb's just got a. Just quick check your folder.
Ooh.
Just before I go out of the building, start getting some shots. This is for people that wasn't at the fan gathering. Just a quick. Don't have to open them all up, it's alright. But this. Is your studio plans.
Well, this was the elevation sheet.
Look at the size of them.
Yeah.
What's that one? Is that Barley Mow?
That's the Barley Mow. So that's the plan of the studio set,
there
which we're going to put in that studio. And then these are the elevations for it to be built.
What's that, A1 size, is it?
Yeah.
There we go.
There we go.
Barley Mow, Colin Russell, Deborah Kerby.
Assistant designer.
Assistant designer. Rigger. Colin's well.
yes.
Thornley Manor.
Still well.
But yeah, all that folder, look at that folder. All them plans. All them plans.
Thank you.
Okay.
Let's man go about the business.
Yes. All right.
Wow. This place. It's a loo room.
This here? No problem. Look at his bloody eyes on the bloke. I'm watching you, sonny. Well, here we go then, chaps. Let's swing round to the ugly mug. Oh, just flip my screen. Here we go. Oh dear. Straighten up the cam. So there you go. The old central building. Me behind the cam most of the time, which is even better. Not like the other ones, we're always on the road. But good, this is part of your history, chaps. Deborah Kerby, Colin Russell, even Wayne at Anglo. Even the chap walking around was, you know, security. But yeah, it's been a hell of an afternoon so far. I mean, I've been here since just before 2, it's almost 20 to 4. But yeah, here you go. I'm thinking, who's this bloke talking to the camera?
Filming toilets. Desperate storyline.
25 years later, the toilets changed, Colin.
They're awful.
They're awful.
They look 25 years old.
Deborah's just gone as well.
Do you, yeah.
I love the little bloke on the door.
It's good, isn't it? He's rather.
The little.
Yeah.
Curious sort of dodgy eyes. Yeah. Like, yeah. Don't graffiti in here.
Yeah. Because this, I'm sure the colour scheme was red. Red and blue or something. I mean, now it's all this.
Brownie colour.
Beige and yuck, and I'm not sure it's good. There we go. Hey, it's good. I'm just glad it's
Toilets down there, the old studio. Yeah. And then look at this, it's massive. Long, long, long.
But isn't it quiet?
It is quiet, it's spookily quiet, isn't it?
Never quiet now, son.
It's quiet.
Okay.
What we're doing next?
Right, this sort of.
That
sort of
Finch Close.
Yeah, Finch Close, yeah, if you like.
Because I haven't a clue about that, I don't remember that.
Well, no, Mike sort of set it up actually, because he remembered, because he worked on the first series.
Ah.
And I hadn't worked on the first series, so I was like, I never.
First series was down Elstree and a little bit of Germany, wasn't it?
Yeah, I see, I never. We can't get out that way, can we? So we're going out the front and then.
Oh, yeah, here we are.
Walk around, or should we go out the. No, go out the front.
We'll go out the back and walk down the side.
No, if we go out the front and then walk round. From
yes.
The, yes, yeah.
Yeah.
I just thought we wanted to go for a walk.
No,
we're not going for a walk.
Oh, dear.
Oh, here we are then, chaps. Just for the camera that's listening, We're just going to go to the side of the studios now, a place called Finch Close. Oh, there you go, look out the back, look. Finch Close is where the Blue Hut was placed at the start of Return of the Seven Part 1, Series 2. Where they had the picture taken by the random builder. Over there, Magnificent Seven.
That's a new garden.
Is it? Looks nice.
And this one's
new, this is. Oh, here we go, this is what I wanted a quick shot of.
1982, 23rd of
February 1982. My God. Here we go. This foundation stone was laid by
in December 1980. And it was just a slag heap.
I came for my interview here with David Chandra in about 82.
Hmm. 83. Were they using this or that?
No, they were over at Gilbrook. I came here and then I was taken up to a place in town, what was it called? Newland House.
Newlands.
I might have been Newland House.
Oh. Newland House, yeah, an office spot there.
There you go.
That's the canteen you see there.
Yes, the sticking out, yeah. It's nice, I do like that.
It's a nice building.
It is.
Yeah.
That's what it's called, King's Meadow Campus.
Press office, wasn't it?
And then in there they turned that into another studio to do cookery programmes.
Cookie.
And that late night show I did once called The Last Word, it was called.
So that was once a studio as well?
They turned it into a makeshift little studio, remember?
Yep. Oh. And then chucked some management out.
Wow. Oh. And here's your main reception going back, chaps.
My camera works better if I turn it on. It's an old trick, but it sometimes works.
He says his camera works better when it's turned on.
Caroline's going to show us.
Okay.
The manuscript store.
Ooh. Yep. Here we go. Sorry.
That was the green room, yeah.
This was the green room, okay.
Yep.
Yeah.
We used to have alcohol in there to get us all livened up.
Okay, now this is the original studio where Auf Wiedersehen Pet was filmed.
Ta-da.
Interiors. Good God, look at that.
Oh, golly.
My God.
I think I may need to take you upstairs to show you, then you can get a view from upstairs.
Oh, definitely, if you don't mind, yeah.
We're going up that?
Shut the door.
Please. Oh, no, we might just go through these stairs now.
Good God.
Could I just ask you to sign in?
Yes.
Yeah, let me cut this for a sec.
Hey, what?
Oh, you've got all newspapers and all sorts. Wow, this is where it all happened.
Ah. The Barley Mow was in here somewhere.
It certainly was. It would have been. Yeah.
And Cross Keys Hotel
everything,
and all the rest.
Everything was set
here.
Yeah.
Ah. But yeah, Auf Wiedersehen, they're not. Oh, there you go. That's where we come in over there.
This is massive, it goes all the way over there, it's huge, it's just an extra floor they put in.
Just for the storage?
No, not at all, this wasn't here at all.
No, I mean this was for the storage for these, to put all the things on an
for
upper level.
Guys, yeah.
Get up
out to the roof as well. Do you come and sit and read stuff in here? No, it is well. It's this temperature because this is sort of what's best for management. So it's temperature. I mean, it was really close. This is going to be. It's a pretty good.
visit, but when John brought me to the offices there, he would walk past our reading room there, and that's where people go to, and then we could just be
there you go, chaps. So, all behind me, all around me now, this is one massive studio, and this is where the barley mow was. And even though fans thought it was the windmill, it wasn't. This is where the Cross Keys interior was. Chaps sit on my stool. All in here. I mean, you look around now, obviously I've swung the camera around a couple of times. You wouldn't think of it, you wouldn't know it. Some of these old black and white pictures of the lads that I've seen, where I'm sat at Pringles Bar, all taken in here. There's everything in here for interior shots. Newcastle Airport interiors, bloody the Working Men's Club. If they've got a problem, that's their problem, mate. All in here, all in this massive studio. And now, don't move the camera. And now this is all sort of archived and manuscripts for the Nottingham University. And it's temperature controlled, so it's nice and cool in here. And this basically is just some of it. Now, what we're stood on now is a makeshift sort of stairs and an upper level, which you can see here. All this has been put in by the university to create extra space, because the space as a flat floor, just a single level, wasn't enough. But look through there, all that black at the back, that's like the edge of the studio. And all down here. So somewhere, I mean, if we could pinpoint, it'll be okay, but I don't know exactly, but you know, Barley Mow was in here, man.
Are you referring to me?
Pringle man. But yeah, here we go. Where the yellow steps are just here, that's where we come in. We had to get permission to come in here. And we was going to just wander out and just get one shot of Finch Close, which is where the Blue Hut was, but we just tried our luck with this lady called Caroline, who's just up here in the red. Thank you, Caroline. Now in the studio where AUF Pet was bloody filming. So yeah, I mean, as you look up, you can see the old rigging, where the lights would be. There you go. Right. I don't know why this camera's looking at me, because I've got the screen the other way, but there you go for now, chaps. Next shot you should see is the car park where the Blue Hut was.
And then I think we then introduced one that touches
He's got his torch. I can always put my phone light on. Oh yes.
Cables.
Studio camera cables. Huge things.
Figure of eight.
You'd wheel the cameras to the side when you do the studio. And each camera has got about 100 metres of big, thick cable. And the camera guys would put the cameras on, the cables on there, that's what they are.
I have no idea.
So obvious to us, but
yes. It's just a feature we've chosen to keep.
Hang your coat on it. Yeah. Gosh.
That's the end of it there. There you go.
That's the door. That's the big door. That would motor across.
That's the main door out.
Electric motor to that. That would across.
Ah.
Oh, yeah. You can see up there, see the site. There used to be curtains on that.
Oh, I see, yes.
That was the site.
Yes.
And at this point, the curtains would be down here, yeah, and you'd be walking behind them.
Well, the backcloth. Yeah, this was the fire lane. You always had to keep the fire lane clear. And the fire brigade would come round and check. And if that wasn't clear, they could just close the studio down.
Yeah.
Just like that?
Yeah. You had a walk around.
Yeah, have a fire lane.
Yes, well, you see, I mean, some of the labelling, and certainly once you get above the levels that we use.
No scenery above the side of the fire lane. So if you had a piece of scenery just here, you had to brace it to the wall higher up. You couldn't watch
that. Ah, well, obviously, we've just used that.
Which is what those screw eyes are for.
The scenery.
Yeah.
Have you hook it onto him.
You couldn't brace it, you couldn't put anything in there. So if you had a piece of scenery here, like that, because it's a tight space and all that, you weren't allowed to brace it down onto the floor, you had to brace it higher.
No, bugs.
So that everybody could, you could clear the studio if there was a fire.
Well, this is it then.
And everything had to be fire retardant, so the firemen would come around with a lighter and try and set a fire to all the drapes.
Yeah. Make sure it didn't catch.
Yeah.
Deal. Yeah. It's still pretty big though, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's not as super small than the other one.
No, no, it's a nice studio. Yeah.
Okay. And that takes to the roof, I assume?
Yes, well, up to the very top there, sort of corridors and I don't know what you call them, but sort of walkways and whatnot.
The gantry as
well. And in 19, when we first came here, 84, early 80s this was evolving. I came here in 84 and it was all
I started in 84.
And they said this was the biggest and most expensive.
It was £21 million to build it.
Television.
Good, good.
82.
Biggest and best in Europe at the time.
Well, we used to scoff at that, didn't we? We thought it was a load of rubbish.
Yeah.
Because the grid wasn't designed very well, was it? The lighting guys always used to complain about it.
Wasn't as good as Elstree, where we came from.
Oh, London, yeah, ATV.
And the BBC are still there making EastEnders.
Yeah, I know. It makes you sick, doesn't it? But the EastEnders.
Okay.
Anglo-American.
I was out in the yard.
Yeah.
Does that lift off then? Is that how people...
Yeah, it does, it lifts off.
Oh, is that how the dinosaurs...
It's actually not one of... Yes, it's not...
it's quite funny, actually, that. Thank you.
Well, that's where we are now, isn't it? Just here, the garden. And then this middle bit. I see. That's a bit, I love things like that, little models.
I know.
I used to make them as a kid.
Did you? You've seen the rabbit?
Oh, yes.
Tim, have you got the rabbit?
Oh, my God. I'll get the dinosaur. Well, yes, the dinosaur's not too happy.
There's the rabbit. Red rabbit.
Just sat on the roof opposite Wayne and Dave. Oh, brilliant.
Where did we do the bit with the hut? Was it here?
No.
It was here.
In here.
Mike recreated it, a bit of the hut.
Oh.
Really?
For the photograph.
Yeah, there was a big lorry part in the way in the background,
that's
so you couldn't see all this.
That's what Wayne was saying, yes.
And there was a blue hut in front to make them look like they were still in Germany.
Did you see any of that building?
No.
No, you wouldn't then, no.
They're I've got a picture of it at home, I printed it out.
Can you send it to me? Because
so it would have been here.
Yeah, yeah. So you don't see much behind, to be honest, Colin. You see the top of the hut and that's it, it cuts off.
That's it, yeah.
You don't see that? Anything like that?
No, nothing at all.
Yeah, but that wasn't built then, was it, all over there?
No, I'm just thinking of the power lines. This was all brand new when we got here. This was a quiet place and it went around there and stopped.
It was Jewson's, the builder's merchant.
Jewson's, yeah. And that was there and nothing
Jewson
else.
It's
very quiet.
You know, wood.
Yeah.
Building super.
Yeah, yeah. No, timber.
Timber,
yeah.
Timber.
So what was this place? This was...
This was a scenery store that came from Elstree before the scenery was ready to be taken into the studio.
Yeah. So it come here.
So you hired this industrial unit, which was next door.
Yes.
Everything had to be loaded and onto lorries and driven around the corner to the other side of the fence and unloaded again. There were ideas to cut a hole in the fence, but nothing ever came.
But the whole thing was here.
Was it?
Prodded up to match the thing at Elstree.
Tell the camera, Debs.
Yeah, the blue hut thing for the first scene.
Return of the Seven, part one.
Yeah, it was here, and Mike Perry was codded it. So I didn't have a clue because I hadn't watched the first series when I came on the show. I'd never watched it. So he codded it up here with vans and the hut to get that little bit. Was there an explosion? Or was that in series one?
That was the end of series one.
Yeah. So they wanted it for the photograph, didn't they?
Yeah, that's it.
That's it.
Yeah. So, all where Colin is,
it's still here, yeah.
Was in use.
Yeah.
And half of these buildings in the area wasn't actually built.
No, Jewson's was over there or over there. One of
Jewson's,
them.
Right.
Yeah. No, nothing was here. It was just, no. It used to be a rubbish dump.
I think a lot of area down this end of Nottingham was, wasn't it, at one point? Like, it was showcased, like I said earlier, with the methane having to escape.
Yeah.
There they are, chaps. Yeah. More of a reflection than the inside, but this was the building that was a scenery store.
And then, yeah, Court Farm next door.
Oh, yeah, of course. Phoenix Court. Oh yeah. What are these names? There you go, Colin having a look. We'll come down and rent it out.
Size of these bleachers, isn't it?
Yeah.
Fits.
It's not been in for a little while, has it? No one's been here.
This was all brand new when we came here.
This was brand new, yeah.
It's sad really, isn't it? Sort of.
It's weird because that bit where Neville was working and gets called to the phone, I mean that was just a few more units down away from Central Ever, the Hump, as you go down Lenton Lane.
Was it?
Yeah, and you look on Google satellite images and the building used to come out like that and then go off at an angle, and that's all been hacked off the front of the building now and put to land at the front. There are more new units built on it called Phoenix Court, I think.
Ah,
but hey chaps, there's a couple of shots of the outside for you, not that you can see much because of the trees. There you go. See if you look round here. What's that thing there? Dodgy. There's my car. So where's your Lenton Lane these days, chaps? I mean, this is how it is. Everyone's pissing off, everyone's going home now. My memory card's flashing, saying 4 minutes of footage left on this camera. But here you go. So yeah, where we've just been footage before, this Finch Close is its real name. Was there in the day, was the same name. That's where your blue hut was, where the lads were having the picture taken. But yeah, just gonna get a few shots of the outside of the building and we'll call it a day. But here's your main gateway in. Just down here. To the Nottingham University Kings Meadow campus. Here's a better shot for you. See, Colin says that that bike rack wasn't there in the day, whatever you want to call it. But yes, here we go. And also, apparently, this outer feature here, the sort of sloped roof, that wasn't there back in days of Auf Wiedersehen Series 2. That was new, Deborah said. And then up the top end there, follow that grass all the way around, leads to the old garden that's there now. And Crossroads done quite a bit up that end as well, apparently. Now in the distance down that way, you'd have seen me on other filming where Neville was working and he gets the phone call saying Brenda's giving birth. That's over there basically, all the way over there, that other unit. But here's the other end of the building. And then obviously your main entrance down there. And we're going to go around the back as well. Nice campus. Nice campus. This is basically admin in this building. Not many students. Anyway, here. This is from up the top end. Main entrance where that lady's just come out down there. And there you go. And look at that all the way back there. Look at it all, man. Jeez. Just round here is the garden. Go through that garden and go through the doors to the building. Takes you to the main bit where the little model of the buildings is that you'd seen on previous footage. Little fountains here, man. There you go. Down there leads you to the little model of the building, that's where it is. And look round, look at it, man, it's bloody massive. That's why you got long corridors. Look at the size of the bloody place. Oh, I don't know how far we can go before I have to walk around the entire perimeter of this place, chaps. I don't know if I have to go back round and get it from the other side. But here you go. It just banks up and goes all the way round, basically. Got the other memory card in, so we've now got 160 minutes. So we'll be okay. There you go. In the distance, Queen's Medical Centre over there. The lower down building, not the big block there. Industrial in the distance here. Anyone got shares in waste cycle? Look at this. There you go. Good God. And here we are, car park in the background there. That's the prop store. So in there, on one of them fixings, is the Crawford Boone security sign, which the head of security said off camera at reception, "I'm having that." I said, "Oh, aye. So yes, he's after that. So here we go then, chaps. This is really at the back end of the studios now. There you go, just there. And then basically the prop store in front of you. Let's go down this steep hill without falling over. There we go. Tidy bit of tackle. That's it, that's where we was earlier. Just at the shutters up now. So go down there, take a left, look up. That's where your Boone security sign is. I know we're not here for Boone, but again, long running production at Central Studios. That one went on for a few series, didn't it? And here we go. What we got up here? Leads to the back of the car park. And yeah, I still can't believe it's bloody paint display, man. Must be weird if you're an employee and you have to do that. Well, I bet they have a pass, don't they? But yeah, sorry for the rambling, chaps. But I do want you to have as full a tour as I can give you. So, this is why you're getting this footage. And round here somewhere, going up to the back of Anglo-American. Further on up and towards the right hand side, I think. Not this building directly to the right there. Oh, there you go. Must be through there. Yeah. Go down there, turn left. There's your Anglo. I'm going to film down here just because I haven't been here anyway. Just want to see how big the car park is. Ah, there you go. Anglo-American Lake, down on the left. I'm sure him going by there, that car. I'm sure he's thinking, what the hell's he doing? Just as this woman is walking up. There you go. All at the back of there, all through basically behind that fence, that's your Finch Close. The unit behind it is where the truck was, and then the blue hut was placed, and then they filmed from there, where the blue hut
place, taken to photo.
Ah, there you are then, chaps. That's your full lap of the campus, basically. You've got all the way around from the entrance, all the way around here. And down to your reception down here. Okay, down there's your restaurant, as you've probably seen before. But all here, look, all here. There you go. All at the back there is basically Finch Close, that's your blue hut. Just remember Finch Close. And that's your blue hut, Return of the Seven Part 1. Okay. There you go, quick way to the roof. Please don't tear that on board. As a viable option if you've got, if you've had enough of your missus. There you go. And then as you walk around here, takes you back to the main reception, and then that will conclude the visit for today. Beautiful place, man. I mean, like Deborah says, it's a little drab here and there, she says, but I never saw it before to compare. To me, I wouldn't have no problem coming here every day to work. Any jobs, like? Any jobs? So, do you think? Here we go. Up to 2 hours, £3. Up to 4 hours, £5. Full day, £7. Jesus Christ. There you go then, chaps. You got a full swing there. There you go. Takes the drive up ahead, he's going to look in at me there. Taxi, sir? No! Don't like taxis, they're a bloody rip-off. Well, here you are then, chaps, here's your full swing. Down there. And then back up here to finish off. There you go. Okay. That's your last bit just there. So yeah, I hope you've enjoyed the old Central Studios footage, Squire. Loyal fans, pet. Colin Russell and Deborah Kerby there, bloody more than generous, giving us stories, telling us which was which, what was what, you know. The head of security we got to talk to someone in manuscripts, as you've seen on the footage, lady in the red coat, Caroline, so thank you to her.
because what was the old studio where they did Auf Wiedersehen, all them interior shots, the main one, is now, you know, sort of limited access sort of room, manuscripts and all that. Climate controlled, which was very, very nice. You go in there, it's like walking into aircon, you're like, oh yes. But yeah, that's it for one day. We'll not bother you with footage driving away from here, because as I say, there's no road cam at the minute, because I filmed my memory card on the other cam. And you don't want to see this face rambling on anymore. Now, whether this is a standalone video or whether I just insert the old airport and Ali Fraser's ass and whatever the other one is I can think of that I've got to get, we'll see. But good news in the form of locations, chaps. Deborah Kerby, when I did sort of describe and remind her off camera when we was walking around to this Finch Close to see where the blue hut was placed, I did say, look, Ali Fraser's ass, it's the one we're still waiting on, Colin, you know, is there anything, is there, you know, anyone thought of it? And Deborah Kirby goes, Ali Fraser's ass, that was Spain. I goes, no. I says, the one that was in Nottingham, well, Leslie St. John says was in Nottingham. I says, the one where Wayne's BM's outside and the jagging Vicky pulls away from Wayne, he's got the swimming pool there. She goes, oh, I know where that was. He goes, oh, aye. And I says, the street it's thought to be from Neil Rigby is a house on Floor 4th Lane at the side of Ruddington. And describing the street, she goes, oh, I know that. She says, I know Ali Fraser's now. It was a house that was set back. It's a big white house. Now, when she says that, I do know the house she means. The only thing that concerns me is, if it was that house, then again, obviously since 1985, a long time's passed, it has had a lot of changes. But number two is, I don't know, well, she was there. I mean, you know, I wasn't. She probably know more than me, 100%. But I'm going to have to sort of look at this on Google, and I might even do it on the way home, to be honest, with the cameras off. Just have another look. But the big white house I'm thinking of, it's got big, massive stone columns. And it's a hell of a difference from the Ali Fraser house we see in the series. So this is one that's going to have to be looked into and investigated a bit more. And at the same time, Deborah did say that she's sort of self-employed in her business, what she does, so I might be able to try and get her out one day and drive her up there and see what she thinks, if it, you know, brings back any memories. I mean, she went, okay, I actually want this one, it was this one next to it, and, you know, all the rest of it. So we'll see what happens. Ali Fraser's house may be found. Good news with the units behind me as well. Remember on the part 3 video where I pulled in and the building come out like that and then went diagonal and it's been knocked down in units at the front now. I referred to that to Colin and Deb, said, oh yeah, how did you know that? So I got one right there. That was right and my video went for nothing. But for now, my stereo with no speakers working, I'm going to go home. And I'm going to see what this rush hour is like. So see you soon, chaps. Hope you enjoyed. See you on the next one. The boys.